Hi, my name's Aaron Powell. I'm a principal cloud advocate at Microsoft, and today we're going to be looking at data types in JavaScript. JavaScript is a weakly typed language. That means that the type system is not as rich and robust as you might find in other languages you've worked with. If you're coming from a strongly typed language like C# or Java, then the type system is going to be a lot more simplistic and a lot more flexible to what you can do. In JavaScript, our variables are defined in a pseudodynamic way, which means that the type that they are is determined by assignment, so we can reassign them. But that does mean that we still have to understand some of the types that we have available to us. Things like numbers, strings, booleans, dates, functions, objects, and arrays are all available in the type system. Now, we only have one number type in JavaScript, and that is actually a float value. JavaScript doesn't differentiate between whether something is an integer value or a float value. It's just a number as far as JavaScript is concerned. We also have some special types available to us that represent different things in JavaScript. Things like NaN, or not a number, to detect whether something that was tried to be converted to a number is actually a valid number to start with. Null and undefined also have special use cases that we have within JavaScript, and they mean different things. Null and undefined are not the same in JavaScript. Because the type system is loose, it can be a little difficult to understand exactly what you're working with from your variables. So for that, we have two operators to help us out, type of and instance of. Type of, we provide a variable to, so we do type of and variable or value that we've received as a function argument, and that will return us a string representation of the underlying type in the JavaScript type system. Now, this is not the same types that we saw on the previous slides, because if we were to do type of array, we would actually get object back. Now, that might be a little bit confusing, but it's because an array is actually just a special object. It has a few additional properties and a few additional functions that a normal object doesn't have, but it's actually just an object under the hoods. We would then receive something like number or string with lowercase starting letters that represent string and number types. Instance of, on the other hand, is used to be able to determine if something was created from a constructor of a particular data type. So if we had our variable and we do variable, instance of, and our constructor type, number with a capital N, string with a capital S, etc., then that will return us a Boolean representation of whether it was created from that constructor type. Now again, this can be a little bit confusing because the constructor for number is not what we would use when we create a variable for number. Let's say we did const 1 equals the literal 1, so just the one character on your keyboard, and we did 1 instance of number with a capital N, that will return false because we didn't create it using the number constructor. It can sound a little bit confusing, but there's different use cases for the different types of operator testing, whether it's type of or instance of, to work out what the data type is. And you'll need to experiment to work out what is the way that you need to be able to test in the applications you're building. But as I mentioned before, the type system in JavaScript is loosely typed or pseudodynamic, which means that we can actually change that at runtime. Let's say we define a variable, well, in this case we'll call it x, and we assign it the string something. On the next line down, we're assigning it the value 1, a literal number 1 off your keyboard. And now, on the third line, we're saying 1 plus hello, and that is being reassigned to x. Now you might be wondering, well, what's the type of x, and what's the value of x? Because 1 is a number, and 1 is a string, how do we add those together? Well, what JavaScript does is it will work out that, well, you can't add those two numbers together because they're not both numbers. So instead, it will try and find a common denominator for them, and it will turn them both into strings. And we would end up with the result of 1 hello as the value of x. So it's now a string type. And that's because it has been able to coerce the value of 1 into a string representation of 1 and then concat them together. You can also get caught out with equality because of the loose type system in JavaScript. In the first example, we're doing x equals 0, double equals, an empty string. Now this will, again, not be an easy thing to be able to do an assertion against because, well, 1 is a number and 1's a string, but what's happened is that JavaScript is going to coerce them to the same type. Both these values are falsy values. 0 is a falsy value in a number, and an empty string is a falsy string value. So it will coerce them into both being a Boolean type. And then false equals false, and that becomes true. So that's why X would be true in the first case. So it doesn't care about the original types, it will just try and attempt to make them the same types if you use a double equals operator. Instead, we should probably use the triple equals operator. This does a type safe comparison between two values. It will no longer coerce them into being the same type. So we'll say, is the number 0 equal to an empty string? Well, no, because they're not the same underlying type, and immediately X will be assigned the value of false. So that's, again, something to be careful of inside of JavaScript because of the loose type system. So it's always recommended that you use the triple equals operator to do type testing.